welcome or welcome back to my channel. As you can see by the title of this video, we are going to be creating mailer boxes or shipping boxes or whatever you want to call them, just doing some custom packaging for our brands. So let's just get right into it. Of course, we are going to be using beauty bundles for this video. If you are new here, Beauty Bundles is a random business name that I made up to do a tutorial for hang tags and bundle wraps a while back. If you haven't watched that video, I will link it in the cards. It was just a way for me to show what I can do as far as like hair companies, since I haven't really had the chance to work with one full on as far as from logo to packaging type of thing. So like I said, we are going to be using this. I do want the boxes to be black. I just love black packaging. I don't know, black gives me luxury. White, I just feel like unless you're like putting them in another box when you're shipping them, they're gonna be all dirty and nasty looking or whatever. But my first boxes, I did them pink, so I am in the middle of the whole thing. Like my lip gloss boxes, if you know me from my lip gloss business, I did have like custom pink mailer boxes that I used to ship wholesale lip gloss in. I still have a few of them, so I will insert a picture in this video so that you can see them. I'm looking for the models, the folder with the models. Where's my folder? Oh, right here. Okay. So, I don't know. These are the ones I usually use for beauty bundles projects, but I feel like I want to use them again. I have used them a few times during this series. Maybe again. Let's see. So for the sizing of the box, the size of this canvas is 1167 by 1037 pixels. This is just the sizing I got from the mock-up that you see on the thumbnail. Remember, if you are creating boxes for your own brand, make sure you measure how big you want your boxes to be. For my boxes that I had for a recollection, I set out, like, if somebody placed the biggest order, which was probably like 6 jars of lip gloss, all I did was place those out and then just measure around them. Like, okay, I can fit 6 jars of lip gloss in this amount of box. So that's a tip on how to make sure you're getting the correct size for your boxes, because you do not these boxes can be very expensive. Custom packaging anyway can be very expensive, so you want to make sure that you are measuring correctly and that you know the correct sizing for everything that you need. And that's not even just with boxes, that's with labels, any type of thing that you're spending money on to get for your business. You need to make sure you know what you're doing, because you can't always get a refund. Okay, so right here I'm just using the what is this called, the gradient that fades into transparency, just to fade out the pictures a little bit. This is one of those videos where I don't really have an idea of what I want to make, but we're here. Okay, and I did want to do one at the bottom. I hope they don't like overlap too bad, but I want it to be like consistent all the way around them. Let's see. It doesn't look like it overlaps. I'm probably gonna add the other fade as well, just to make sure. Oh, that's overlapping. Okay. You can still see it. Why? And then I'm going to move them down because I do see. This is the only one that doesn't want to act right. All I'm doing is using the arrows on the keyboard to move them just a little bit. You can see it and it's kind of bothering me, but that's not the focus of the video. So, whatever. I did want to... Let's see what some of our other stuff will look like in here. You know, I've gotten into adding the sparkles and stuff. So let's see. I don't know why I can't find anything today. Like, I don't see any of my folders. I think I just want like a solid one. Maybe this one. So just a little bit and put it all the way in the back so it's not cut. Hello, it's like right here on the thing. You can see it. Is it chopping it? Let me see. It doesn't look like it's chopping anything now, but I could see the transparency thing behind it and it was gonna bother me, so I'm just gonna move this one to the back as well. I just said, okay, there you go. I'm messing up stuff. Okay, and maybe a little flare. Okay, these elements that I'm using, these are some that I did add into Canva. I've been using them quite a bit in our videos, but we also did have another video where I used mostly Canva elements, and they do have things like the light flares and stuff like that. So there are some free ones in Canva, so you don't have to like pay and do the stuff that I did to get these types of elements. Okay, so I think this is gonna be the top of the box. Yes, maybe. Okay. So for my mock-up, I do have a, what do you call it? The inside of the box as well. So I'm going to name this top and I'm going to name this one inside because the sizing for that is the same. So I can just do that in one Canva document instead of doing two different ones. So for the inside of the box, I do want another photo. I think I'm gonna change this, to be honest. I think I want this to be the inside. Okay, so I think I want this to be the inside of the box. I don't know. I guess I should have figured this out before I started this video. But would it be me if I did? I appreciate y'all for going on this journey with me, okay? Because I never know what I want to do. Okay, so I made a rainbow gradient, duh, because I made this rainbow that's in this logo. I think I'm going to bring that in and try to do something with that too. So give me just a second because I got to find it. Okay, so this is the gradient that I made. I want to do like this around the box. I think like a very thin border, like I did on the oh wait, that wasn't a YouTube video, but right here, like I did on these labels, like a really thin rainbow around the box. And I'm just going to add a black rectangle to make it as thin as I want it to be. Okay, and I'm just gonna center it because I know that is not centered. Okay, I'm gonna make this black. So now it looks like a border. Then I'm just going to grab the rainbow and the black. Hold on. Okay, the rainbow and the black square, I'm gonna group them together and move them to the back. Like that. So I think I'm gonna keep this consistent around the outside of the box. I just don't know what I want to put on the top of the box. Cause I think I want this to be the inside, but I want it to say something else. Let's just do new hair, who this. Cause I feel like that's the attitude we all have when we get our hair done. So let's just do that. Do I want it bigger? Do I want it centered? Let's try this. So the accent color for the label that I made was yellow, so I think I'm going to keep that consistent. It was like a really bright yellow though. Okay, like that. And then I'm going to put for some reason this is not going to work for me, so yeah, there we go. Okay, because I want this to be like really small, and of course not this font. I'm going to use a thinner font, just going to stick to what we know. Wait, I like this one, but I guess that's something that needs to be used in a different video. Let's make this smaller. I kind of want this to be yellow too. Like that. Okay. So. Ooh. Maybe not. But since the logo is kind of like cut off, let's see. Maybe not. I don't know, I kind of like it. Okay, so I did have words that I wanted to add here, but the rectangle thing kind of threw me off. So I don't know what I was going to put. So we're just going to leave the logo. And this is the top now. And then this is going to be the inside of the box. Okay, so let's move on to the front of the box. So for the front of the box, this sizing is 1216 by 296. Keep in mind, like we talked about before, make sure you measure whatever you want your boxes to actually be. I'm just gonna copy and paste that rainbow border from the other side of the box and place it on here. So I have to ungroup it because I need to resize it. Let's see. Just gonna move this down to about the same as it is on the other side and adjust this part right here. I feel like the top part is fine, but because that seems like it's really good. So I'm just gonna adjust the black too. And that needs to be fixed at the bottom, but it's like jumping. So when you zoom in on stuff, it helps you move it. See how little it moves compared to how much it moved when I was zoomed all the way out. It makes it easier to move stuff. Okay. So for the side of the box, this is the front of the box. But I'm gonna do one side of the box as well, because I think that's all you can see on the mock-up. I want more of the rainbow shine. It's not letting me crop it. No. Because they're both like the same color. I don't like that. Okay. Maybe I should have just used a frame for the side. Let's see if that makes it look better. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just go in Elements, choose Frame, and then there is a square one that I can use. Square, rectangle, something. I think it's this one. Nope, that's not the one I can resize. There's one that lets you resize it, which I should have just scrolled down here. There we go. It's a grid, not a frame. I always do that. Okay, so this one, it lets you resize it. And I'm just going to drag and drop this. What is this? Oh, no, that doesn't. I sure had confidence in it. But it didn't let me do it. So I would have to... Let's see. There's a way to do it. I could just go in and copy and paste the rainbow like this. Copy and paste it. And then make the border, which that's a lot. I would do it, but for the sake of this video, I'm not going to do it. So I'm just going to leave it here. I just didn't want it to be that yellow and green. All right, so all I want to do is add the website to the side. Well, one is the front, one is going to be the front of the box, one is going to be the side of the box. So I kind of just realized that my microphone was not on the entire time I was doing that other stuff. So if I don't, I'm going to do a voiceover because I feel like something important was said. I don't know. So I thought I wanted like a message on it, but I don't know. I'm just gonna put your bundles everywhere. I didn't want it old, but let's see. It's kind of cute. Okay, so this is going to be the side of the box, and this is going to be the little front flap of the box. Because my mic was off, y'all didn't hear me. But I'm still debating on whether I want this rainbow here or not. I'm probably going to fix it, but that's pretty much it for designing the box. We're going to go ahead and put the mock-up together in this video. If you want to watch that portion, stay tuned. But we are going to go into Photoshop to do that. All right, so getting into Photoshop, I know this series is Canva and we've done a few things in Photoshop, but I do like to show y'all other ways to get things done. You can use mockups in Canva, and I think I'm gonna try in this video just to see, but sometimes the mockups don't work, so I don't use Canva for mockups. So this is the box mockup that I have. I'm going to just go ahead and click in and change everything as far as colors and add the designs that we created. So this layer right here is the front part of the box, which is this. I'm gonna go ahead and add our design that we created in Canva. If you want to, you can delete all of this. Most of the time, I just put it on top of the design. You're not gonna see it, so it really doesn't matter. The front of the box is this one, and you see how it just fits like it's supposed to. All I do is come in to the mockups and get the size of this canvas, and then I just put that sizing in Canva so that it's easier to use the mockups. Okay, so you can see the little border. Just a little bit. As you can see, I did go in and fix the rainbow border because I knew once I got in Photoshop, I was gonna be irritated that it didn't look like everything else. So I just went ahead and fixed it. Okay, so this is the top of the box. And now you see we have our cute box. I'm gonna go ahead and change this brown. Let me zoom in. I'm gonna change this brown to black because of course we want everything to look the same. Right here it says color cardboard. Yeah, okay, I can change it right from there. Why did I do white? Oh, look at our box, y'all. Stuff like this excites me so much. Okay, so this is the outside of our box. I don't ever use the backgrounds that come with the mockups. I always turn the background off, that way it's transparent. And when I save it, I can put it in Canva and add it to the thumbnail or whatever I want to do. So this is the outside of the box, and we're gonna go ahead and do the inside of the box too. All right, so right here we have the inside of the box. As you can see, it's just really solid colors. They only have like a design, well, text right here. And then we can go in and change the outside part of the box too, which I guess I should have made a different design for this one, but you know how to do it now, so yeah. So right here, I'm just gonna turn stuff on and off so I can figure out which part of the box it is. This portion right here is just this little flat part, and it's just gonna be black. So all I'm gonna do is take a rectangle and make it black. And I'm going to copy this rectangle. That way I can just use it for the rest of the box. Okay, and I'm just gonna go down each one and add the color, and we'll come back when we get to the design. So that is pretty much it for just that basic part of the box right here. And if you actually had the box on this side, this is where the website would be. So that's this part. I'm going to add our other design that we created in Canva on this side. And why this one didn't just snap? And we're just gonna imagine that it's on the other side as well. So now we have it right here. It's not like my border is not how I want it to be. You can see it a little bit, but it's not, oh my gosh, it's not where I want it. Is it this one? Yeah. So I'm just going to bring this back in. You know what? I got an idea. That's probably why it didn't snap. Okay, if I do it like that, let's see. And I'm just gonna turn that placeholder off. It shows a little bit, but it's not, I don't don't want it to snap in place, but I want it to be closer to the edges. So I may have to add a black rectangle behind it just so it'll look how I want it to look. That's closer, but still not quite it. And then right here, we're going to add our last design, which is this one, I think. Nope, not that one. It says back. I think it's this. Nope. This is one thing I hate about mock-ups with a lot of layers. I love them because that means I can customize more, but having to go through all those layers, yeah. All right, so this is the inside of the box. Look at our box. Ooh, yeah. It's so cute. Okay, so right here we have that same thing going on, which is the color of the cardboard. And I'm just gonna come right here to the one that says color cardboard, make it black, and this it. So that's what I was saying, like once they opened the package, I should have did a design for right here as well. But it is still cute. It's still kind of giving what I want, so yeah. So right here in this mock-up, you can, you can customize the tissue paper. It's the color right here, and you can also add a design to the tissue paper as well. I didn't create a design, but all I'm gonna do is just add the Beauty Bundles logo. I think I want it black, or no, should I do it rainbow? Let's see what the rainbow is gonna look like. Cause who y'all know got rainbow tissue paper? Nobody. Okay, thought so. What is this? I can close this. No, I saved it already. We've done that one. Look it up. Ooh. Who y'all know got rainbow tissue paper? And I wanna add a logo too. But I don't know if I have it in black. Let's see if I have the Beauty Bundles logo in like black or white or something. I don't think I have it in like full black or full white. I don't. So I'm going to take this one, since this is the one we used on the design anyway. Let me just make sure it's where it's supposed to be. And I'm going to create a clipping mask. So all I'm gonna do is make a rectangle, and I'm going to make the rectangle white. I'm gonna turn off the stroke on the rectangle because we don't need that. And I'm going to make sure it's above the logo, which it is. I'm gonna right click and just do create clipping mask, and it makes the whole thing white. So that's your Photoshop tip for today. Is this centered? Well, I guess the rectangle wasn't, but that doesn't matter. Okay, so when I hit save, and okay, see, so now we have our inside of the box as well. And we're gonna do one more thing, and then I'm gonna let y'all go, I promise. I cannot let y'all go from this video without telling y'all where to get your boxes printed. Well, no, giving y'all a suggestion, I guess, of where to get your boxes printed. This is the vendor that I use for my boxes. This is a US vendor, so the prices are the prices, okay? I paid quite a bit for my boxes. I think they were I don't even remember, but it was a lot of money. Okay, so right here is where you can purchase your mailboxes. This is a very easy brand to work with. They allow you to go in, like, you know your price before you start designing. You choose the sizing for your boxes. Keep in mind, this is what I meant when I said make sure you know what size boxes you need, because you're gonna pay some money for these boxes. They have the standard white, you can get glossy, the craft brown, which is that brown that our mock-up had. You can choose whether you want outside, inside printing, no printing at all, and your quantity. I didn't get the 100. I maybe got 50 boxes, if that. I don't think I got 100 boxes. But as you can see, for 250, you're paying $3.44 for a box. So your total is going to be about $860. Shipping is probably going to be $30 to $40. So these boxes are a bit expensive, but for me, being the extra person that I am, I think they are very much worth it. But it all depends on you and your budget for your brand. But this is the vendor that I have used. I highly recommend them. They allow you to get a proof of your design before they start printing. If something goes wrong, they're gonna call your phone. They're gonna call you. This ain't working. Do you have this? Do you have that? I highly recommend them. But again, their printing is very pricey. If you are one of those people that are on a budget and you have time to wait on boxes to be made, I do recommend Alibaba. I haven't ordered boxes from Alibaba. I've only done like my custom lip gloss tubes and those things like that. But it is cheaper. You just have to order more. But anyways, that is the end of this video. I really hope you all enjoyed this video, and I will see y'all in the next one. Bye.